last lecture we have learned about the components of the foods and different types of nutrients. There are the five types of nutrients, that is carbohydrates, fats, proteins, vitamins and minerals. Related to this, the essential two things are there, that is roughage and water. Now, to be a healthy person, we should have the balanced diet, right? We should have the proper balanced diet. Now, what is a balanced diet? What is meant by the balanced diet? Balanced diet means the food you should have in the right proportion. You should get in a right proportion. A diet that contains the right proportion of the nutrient, that is called as an balanced diet. That is called as a balanced diet. A food that contains or a diet that contains a right proportion of nutrient.
Next is sorting. What is the sorting? Now there was summer vacation.
the mother might have prepared some pickles. So what she has added in that more amount of salt. So that is called as a salting. So you can preserve it for the longer period of time. Then next is sweetening. Sweetening means you are eating the jam. Are you eating the jam? Yes. So how it is the taste of the jam? It is sweet. So that it is called as a sweetening. The more amount of the sugar is added in that particular food item to preserve it from the jam. So that process is called as a sweetening. Pickling means what? Pickles. Pickle, your mother might be making the different types of pickle. In that the number of chemicals she might be adding in that. Right? So it preserve it for the longer time.
Now what is meant by the diseases? the lack of the nutrients such as protein, carbohydrates and fats. So how to recover this? How to overcome this? So the person or the child is suffering from this, he should be given the rice, wheat, the resource of carbohydrates, the things, the foods which is rich in carbohydrates, fats and protein. So that food item should be given to that particular child. For example, rice, wheat, potato, maize, egg, etc. Now the next is kosher corn. The next is kosher corn. This is caused due to the lack of protein. This is caused due to the lack of protein. If the protein is less, now see, you people are growing. If you will not eat a protein food, very, very rich food, then you can face this problem, kosher corn. This is due to the lack of protein. The abdomen, what are the symptoms of this? The abdomen of the child gets swollen. The abdomen of the child gets swollen and dulled out. The legs become thin. The child has become, the leg of the child become very thin. The abdomen gets swollen. Swollen means it becomes little bit high. And the legs become very thin. So the child should be given rich source of protein such as egg, fish, meat. The child should be given egg, fish, meat, which are the rich source in protein. Then next is anemia. The next is anemia. It is caused due to the lack of iron. This disease is caused due to the lack of iron. So what are the things can be seen in that particular? What are the symptoms? What are the symptoms we can see in this? Extreme fatigue, weakness and pale skin. Pale skin means, see, the grandparents, the skin is totally pale. Am I right? It is really soft. So that is a pale skin. And what things should be given to the child if the person is suffering from anemia? He should be given egg, pulses, dates, green leafy vegetables. The next is goiter. This is caused due to the lack of iodine. See, here it comes near the thyroid gland. It comes, this goiter, it comes near to the thyroid gland. See, you can see swelling of the thyroid gland present near the neck region. So this is totally a swollen. So this is caused due to the lack of iodine. So the person should be given iodized salt, seafood, which is rich in the salt. Now next is improper development of bones and teeth. The next is improper development of bones and the teeth. This is due to the lack of calcium. This is due to the lack of calcium. So the bones and the teeth become weak and brittle. Means the if our teeth and bones are not properly, if you are not having the calcium food, then the bones, they become very weak and brittle. Brittle means it can break easily. So you have to take care of yourself. So if the things are like this, if the child is suffering from this, so what sources of food we should give him? We should add milk, green leafy vegetable, carrot. We should eat the number of fruits and pulses. Then next is nighttimes. The next is nighttimes. It is caused due to the lack of vitamins. It is caused due to the lack of vitamin. Vitamin A means the person cannot see in a dim light. If the light is dim, the person is unable to see. So that is caused due to the nighttimes. So that is called as a nighttimes. So the person should be given the leafy vegetable. You should give a leafy vegetable. The next is beriberi. The next disease is a beriberi. This is caused due to the lack of vitamin B. This is caused due to the lack of vitamin B. The skin becomes dry and scaly. See, during summer season, your skin is totally becoming dry and scaly. Like that, the skin becomes an extreme weakness we see in such a person. So for that also the person should be given milk, egg, meat to then tomato, citrus food. The next is ricket. The last is ricket, that is it is caused due to the lack of vitamin D. It is caused due to the lack of vitamin D. For the bone, what happens, what are the symptoms we can see? The bone aches, less, and bending of the spine. This is totally your spine. This is the spine bend. So these are some symptoms of this. So what sources of food we should give them? We should give milk, fish to have in the rich source of food. We should provide them. So these are all non-communicable diseases. Once again, I will repeat, non-communicable diseases means they are not spread by person to person. So these are the non-communicable diseases. Marasmus, kwashiorkor, anemia, goiter, improper development of the bones and teeth, night blindness, beriberi, scurvy, and rickets. These are the non-communicable diseases. That another part of the diseases is a communicable disease. So what is meant by the communicable disease? The diseases which are spread from one person to another. So that is called as a communicable diseases. This diseases is spread by one person to another. For example, now you can see corona. It is a virus. Am I right? So there are the communicable diseases. They are spread by the one person to another. These diseases is also called as infected diseases. This diseases is also called as an infected diseases. These are spread by the germs, by the microorganism, by the microorganism. See, there are some communicable diseases, bacteria, virus, protozoa. These are the microorganism and the diseases. By the bacteria, we can cause the tuberculosis, cholera, pneumonia, plague. These are the diseases are caused by the bacteria. And by the virus, common cold, flu, chickenpox, AIDS. These are caused by the virus. And by protozoa, malaria and dysentery. Malaria and dysentery. These are the two main types of diseases. Once again, I will repeat it. Non-communicable diseases are non-communicable and communicable diseases. These are some diseases which are not spread by the person to person, and these are the diseases which are spread by the person to person. Today we have completed the balanced diet. Today I have told you about a balanced diet, how to preserve the balanced diet. Then we have learned about the diseases and the two types of diseases. Am I right? So today's homework is that you have to read the lesson. You have to remove the new words and read the lesson twice. Write the new words in your notebook. Thank you.